Let's see if all the practice paid off offline. Just as a thing. So 131, okay. Reminder to myself. Okay. Yeah, I can't put off any longer. I got my splits typed up here. I will probably reset in the warm underwear once or twice if it doesn't go well. Actually, that's what I'll do in a sec here. Let me just check what my actual time was for that in my PB. Because if it was bad, then I won't bother with it. That's not how. There you go. Cool, cool, cool. Alright. Now I don't have any more chance to procrastinate. So I can. Okay. So 3, 2, 1, go. For once. Stupid RNG of where that little mega pillar and rocky are in the right hand side is really annoying. Ugh, bad. Why? Why are all the animals being annoying this time? I'm gonna be picky for the first little bit just because A, it's very, very early game. But I literally have everything routed out now to one extra fight. The experience will be two less than it'll be two less than some levels I need. So 3, 2, 1, go. If I end up fighting one more, it's not the biggest issue. But for a PB attempt, I actually will try. I know, right? Nope. See, the thing is, I have no problem doing this. Like, I'm not gonna bother resetting the game again. So how you doing, Juno? And Parthic. Like, it's not a hard reset or anything. I messed that up. Welcome to PB attempts, everyone. I knew that first little bit would be weird. Close enough. Semi. I'll take that. Why is that blob so far right? There you go, that's much better. All the birds want to be on this side, which is nice. Happy Canadian Thanksgiving to people. Slightly hit the ledge there. Okay, they actually want to behave. If they're on the left-hand side, that's really annoying as well. Oh, sorry to hear that. Hopefully you're doing well, though. I didn't get too bleed. No shield? No shield. My world record's gone by for... I actually moved my T. I almost smacked it over when I was trying to split. Oh well, that's a me problem. No. Well, whatever. I thought I had a double jump. If I mess up one more battle, I'll reset it again. How you doing? Not other than tired as hell, but you know. This time. And we'll move it over here. It's not in front of the screen yet. My split is the one on the keypad, so reaching with my left hand doing that's kind of annoying. Mini tar. They have one extra skill point because I was not supposed to fight the extra battle. Oh, geez. Ah, okay, yeah, so you did do a lot of stuff. Where's the birds? Thank you. I need some healing items. Okay, can anyone tell me if I equipped the Minotaur set? That's the burn team I need. I didn't see. I'm pretty sure I did because I just made a comment on them having one more skill point than they should. So I'll assume past Sean was good. If not, I'll reset it. It's only like 8 minutes to get to the Minotaur anyway. Ah, I did that ideally there. Okay, where are you? Nope. You're gonna jump at me, I knew that. There is no nice way of going down. Okay, cool, it's there. I accidentally hit the X button. There's two Magma Moths there that are dark shifted. No, okay. Just gonna reset. No, I don't wanna update them. Actually, sure, we'll update them. Compare guest best segments. There you go. Again, welcome to PB attempts. I don't tend to grind PBs, but okay, I did have it. Once I get the double jump, I will be fine. That's the only concern I have. So 3, 2, 1, go. There you go. Ah, I had to stop there. That's not gonna be good. Okay, you guys are there, that's fine. Yeah, my desk is a mess right now. I have a lot of estate stuff and whatever on top of it, notes, phone calls, or phone numbers and stuff like that, all ready to go. So if anyone ever sees my desk, it's gonna be quite chaotic right now. Birds. Okay, two, and then I don't care about the third one because I can jump there. Ideally, I don't want to fight an extra time for this entire battle, or in this entire run. It's a segmented run I was doing as resetting the game. That's why the... Okay, that was ideal. I was resetting the game when it came to... What's it called? Any extra fights, just to make sure I had all the teams set up. That's a bit spicy there. Oh, darn it. No, I messed that up. Where are you guys? Ah, you're fine. I can get over all ya. Almost. Okay, do we get a decent... Okay, we do. Quiet, buddy. Monk, there we go. There's a chance of getting three bleed there. So, you know, all the better. Oh, almost missed this. That's extremely crucial. Instead, this guy didn't troll me this time. So I should explain the run a little bit right now because, yeah, I worked a lot on it. You can see the splits. Warm underwear has its own spot right now because basically all the splits correspond with a team that I made to do a fight. So the monk split revolves around the monk team. Big surprise, right? Still, this one's not going to be as decent, but the movement was clean at least getting here, so. I was hoping for criticals. That's because I didn't have a fight there as well. So, when it comes to... There, you quit the Minotaur. I don't want to see skill points, which is why I don't want an extra fight, because my experience to a level right now will be like 2. So that will mess me up in thinking I didn't load the teams properly, which is why I don't want any extra fights, even though one extra level could make a big difference for winning fights. Though Zosmos 2, Marduk? I'm just going to take it slow and dodge them. And the Mad Lord fight are a little bit spicy. Julia tends to go long. Elder Gel's annoying. Otherwise, it's all pretty good. And this is like my favorite little strat of the platform goes beneath it. So you can technically do that. Again, once I get the double jump, I can actually dodge things properly. Just playing like 99% of the game, you know, with a double jump versus not is very jarring. I don't know if I'll reset on warm underwear not first try, or the rawhide, I should say. But I can skip this. If I can grab this key and just go, I'd be able to actually get, I guess it wouldn't be that bad, but it'd prevent me a little bit backtracking. Which way are you guys going? Okay, two of you are there. Yeah, we'll stay away from you. Curve around there. Oh, thank you for the follow. And I went the wrong way. That distracted me. I'm gonna take it slow. I don't wanna fight you guys. I'm sorry, I don't have, my splits are actually in, ooh, that was actually good. My splits are actually in front of my Twitch dashboard, so. We saw litter there, kill a slime, or blob. Because we have eagle, we can actually not use double jump boots to get the key here, so we can get both keys in one go. I'm just not gonna bother. For the follow. So you're supposed to be able to either use a mushroom or the eagle to get up there with an extra jump, essentially. There we go. This is the second key. Take a little second there. Go around these guys, hold left. I can scratch my eye because this is an empty room. Once I get to the boss, I can move that so I can see if I can think properly. So, oh, it's just DRK. Sorry, I always have it my layout. I just realized that. So, hold left. There you go. It's nice and clean. I got very good at doing this early part of the game because I kept messing up a lot. So, fun fact: you actually don't need double jump boots to escape this pit. You can just use the bird. I like showing that off because it's kind of funny. There you go. And we'll come back here later. Don't worry, this treasure chest is extremely crucial. I totally won't forget it later. No, thank you. There you go. Oh, I jumped. I shouldn't have. So we have fatal upkeep on the little guy here, and we have burn, multi-burn on the moths. So all we have to do is really get one more set of burns going. We have 6 in total, blip, blip, blip. So now we can switch to the warm underwear one. either way. Fast plane. It's a survey plane. They're looking at the pipelines again, most likely. So now we actually have double jump, so I actually do stuff I want to do. And this makes it simple, because no matter where these guys are, I can avoid them entirely. Despite Catzerker's not existing, I'm actually really surprised how many times that is a run-ender for me. Jump here and hold this, so we can skip to, we'll hold B to skip the earliest possible frame. I do love the movement here. Oop. Got caught there. Can make this jump here by doing that. Oh, wow. There you go. It's a little bit tighter than I thought it was. I thought there was a little more height there. That made up for it, though. Not really, but... So I will give this one attempt. So what's 9 minutes? I honestly, I'm kind of okay with that. Because it looks like I fought quite a bit on my PB. So I think any time save is a good time save, if that's the case. Hold left here, jump off this one. Do a double jump and a flight. I cross the screen entirely. There's no easy way of doing this one here. Love the music here. So this is annoying because I want to see where the crystal slime is, which is very nice. So we saw the teleporter. That's very nice of us. Fell. Thank you. Oh no. That's a flub. I was thinking I didn't have to do that. Oh. Oh no. Anyway. So this is the one smoke bomb. All three are routed out. Is now I have a unicorn. There we go. So hopefully I get a 6-star in this next fight, or a 5-star and get a rawhide. So this is the one and only fight I'll be doing that's not essential in this entire run. Because I can potentially get rawhide early. If not, I'll do mountain. Heal up. Nope. So we're going around the mountain. So if we would have got the rawhide there, we wouldn't have to do this entire segment. So this is a minute time loss, maybe? Thank you. Because that's the easiest fight you can do, and again, you can 6-star it if you do things properly. But the rawhide is not a guaranteed drop there. But it is a very high chance nonetheless. So I got the rawhide from the treasure chest, now I can leave. 13 minutes. Yeah. Still pretty bad. About 40 seconds ahead of my PB right now. That will change very drastically later. So it'll be the Mogwise here. Thank you. I almost fell off there. We have to go beneath the part here. Nope, almost did it. Open it for good measures, hold B. Then we can jump down here. Do a long full jump here. And then here we need the coat plus 4. So you jump to the right of this. You can do the mount and get this treasure chest here. And that treasure chest is used for basically the rest of the game after the Magma Chamber. We'll jump here. Number 2. There's a couple of rooms I want to use the Sycophantom's ability in. The answer is 235 for the record. This time, jump down to the right of this pillar. You can kind of do a C going around this entire thing, just because the water helps you on that one. Oh wait, there you go. Changed to the right boss team. That doesn't really take much time. If I just only do it once, that's fine. You guys gonna be nice? Yeah, you guys gonna be nice. Nope, messed up. So we don't actually have to do the puzzle down here anymore because we don't get the Bell Ring plus 4, but we do need the Crystal Shard there because that's very useful. And it's the quickest Crystal Shard in my way currently. And doing that puzzle with a mount is honestly quite cool. A little bit difficult to do, but it's possible. So now it is... This would be the other Sycophantom room I would do the battle in. Just get them on the left-hand side and then just them. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Do that. That one there. I'll move the T once I have the mache. I moved it back into the problematic area, so splitting's kind of annoying right now. Let's move that there. There you go. I always have a drink with me when I stream, but doing speedruns, it tends to be in front of there you go. It tends to be in front of what I want. So we'll just start this. I don't have to do anything other than revive. So yeah. Because the extra... There you go. There we go. 1749 is not bad. if you guys want to behave. You do, sorta. You guys were kind of standing menacingly there. Okay, cool. That's all good. This is on now the right-hand side. Well, that's the whole point, right? Like... the whole point is, like, three fatal upkeeps is kind of bonkers when it comes to the excess damage. Then after that, it's a bleed damage, or bleed-based team. Actually, it's a mixture of both, truthfully. Okay, cool. They wanted to behave as well. That was another possible Sycophantom Phantom room. The elephant's ability is great. Unfortunately, I can't use my spinner anymore because I gave him a different ability. I used to love having the creepy guy follow me. This is another room, which, you know, actually, I will just respect this. So now we can go fight Zosmos 1, which is here. And this team's backwards. You think you want to use the Oculus to lead, but you don't. You want to finish with them. So you want to use the two Megamoths to hit the Grummy at the start, and then you want to be able to have them essentially all die and then just keep Oculus around, because this team actually can't really fight Oculus. Four is good. So they're going to do two Acid Tempests, and they'll get rid of both of them. So now I can just do a Poison. Do that and get some damage on you. And then, yep, there we go. Then we want to get rid of you as fast as possible, because you actually hurt quite a bit. So next turn he's gone, that's fine. Oh, we have Encapsulate, okay. Encapsulate, Phoenix Tear, and attack. Tempest, Phoenix Tear, Phoenix Tear. Let's get some damage on him. Don't care, really don't care, and then I'll survive this. Just slightly over sub 20. So this is Akut and then the forest bosses. I reread this one just because there's no reason not to kill him when I have a chance. Oh yeah, you take me off my horse during that. I forgot that. That's why I have him as a separate split, because technically my team name is Forest Bosses. And funny enough, he still can't beat these guys. So. Smash A to win. Now we use the Crystal Shard we picked up. We go back here, and we can fight Will. Oh, is it bad RNG or something, or? Oh no, Will won anyway. And we're actually too lazy to just go back down, so what we can do is just do this. Just to make sure I have the right forest bosses. Yeah, cool. The one skill point scared me there. That's why. So you talk to him first, and you can stay on your horse. If you don't, then, you know, he kicks you off. So we still have one smoke bomb. So we still have to make good use of that. There we go. I want you. Just because I don't trust these guys in the hallways here. Let's make them do a little glitch. See? I love doing that. So there's the mad eyes kind of fly to the right there, and I don't like them. This one I can actually do. This is fine. Actually, I should have the bird. Nope. There you go. I think this is fine now. Yeah, cool, we're good. And then... Oops, I forgot that. So what we want to do is grab one of you guys. Actually, let's just preempt this entirely. So I want to get the stronghold dungeon keys first. And the combo potions here. It's one of the treasure chests we pick up. See, I contemplate picking up the crystal shard as well in the dungeon cell that you need the fungi to open. And it wasn't worth it in the end, just because I have to, if I were to teleport back, I'd have to come back here anyway to do the mount to get to get the runestone piece and teleporter. There used to be a skip here, but that's not done. Huh. Dark glowfly. I will switch to you. There we go. I don't like that pillar. I also want to make sure I don't get fights there. I have one last smoke bomb. And before I can buy more smoke bombs, I need to be able to use that for what I want. So, I can't... The reason I'm not using the mount here is there's so many goblins in this cave system that are jumpy. I don't like them or the flyers here. That's why I'm doing that. So we got the runestone piece, and then now we can... From here, it's safe. Just realized where I was. I need this one verdant gem. And then we can see the teleporter, go yay. See this, proc this for later. And we can teleport back to the stronghold dungeon. There we go. Now we can go up and grab both keys. check out. Grab the bird. Oh, barely made it. Grab you again. We count to 19. Contemplating that treasure chest, and I don't want it. There you go. Get one key. How long is the fishing thing active for? Is it like a weekly event, or is it like a permanent thing that you're just trying? There's two moths here, which could be annoying for height, and they're fine this time. Don't talk to that guy. We just need the second key over here. Oh, yeah, we did that. Well, there you go. I'll change that split to say ancient forest keys as well. Can barely make this jump. Nope. All right. Goblins, I respect. They're little jumpy guys. I don't like them. So we are going to purposely do that. Again, we want to burn the crap out of this guy. We'll survive one round. Thunderbolt? Yeah, Thunderstorm, yeah. So what will happen is the guy in the back will be revived. These guys will get decked. I'll get this guy out. We just target him down completely. So now both of those two will die, and I can focus on just doing fire damage against the Minotaur there. So just revive him just to make sure everything's fine. Do that and they'll hopefully, yeah, thank you. It's going to hopefully take out. There you go. Don't care. Don't care. Do the Phoenix tier. That's good. Not what I wanted, but he can't stay alive next turn anyway, so it's all good. Let's do that. Do that. There you go. And we win. Sorry, there's no split here. So I'm actually one experience away from a level. It's quite annoying, but whatever. No, I want you. Because you guys are annoying. Okay. Again, use this guy for here. Oops. I just like doing that noise. Anyway, so this is the funny one, is even though our main threat should technically be the Goblin King. There we go. We can get some damage on him first. But the Goblin Shaman is the only one that can actually do damage against these guys. So if you just go against him, you're actually pretty much ideal. The other guy will die next turn anyway, so. It's all good. We'll encapsulate. And again, do that. And I win after this. I'm not doing a lot of damage, but the chip damage, though. Yes, 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 thank you. I don't need those items there. And then what we will do is we will switch to Overworld 1, then back to the forest bosses. Because now we can use these guys. You can't tell my muscle memory thinks they're on the second page. There we go. So by doing that, I can switch all the overworld abilities to the front. There we go. Okay, hoping for a little bit more weakness, but whatever. It's enough status effects for now. Please to attack. Okay. Thankfully, we can't die. All three of them can't die in the same turn, essentially. I just need to keep all three of them revived for the fatal upkeep damage. That's the main thing for this. And I win no matter what now. Yeah, because he didn't kill. Now this is all them. So now we do Stronghold Dungeon bosses. Because now we are Keeper Lancer, we can actually buy stuff. So please pardon the horrible... thank you. So what we will do is, first of all, we're not going to buy any of this stuff. We are going to buy crystal shards and smoke bombs. Oh, and potions. Sorry, that was the other one. Potions are very handy later. We'll get bigger potions, but the regular potions do make a big difference. Oh, no, no, no. I want Stronghold Dungeon bosses. Actually, no, we don't need to upgrade yet. That's fine. So because we grabbed the keys, we can actually switch to you. Will's here. Oh, then he goes away. I want... Nope, 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 nope. Oh, okay, well, whatever. We have the fish here. Oh, I wanted the eagle. I saw the yellow and I went for the eagle. Those are grapes for the record there. You don't really need them. Excuse me? Something messed up. Stronghold Dungeon bosses? Okay, they messed up. Forest bosses, then. Okay, I keep messing up here. This is really annoying. There you go. I must have got one thing wrong. Matter, I win. Weird. So, asshole bosses again. We'll try one more time. Nope. Okay, cool, whatever. I'm not gonna bother. I can probably cheese a fight. Three big guys in a hallway, not a big fan of it. Actually, just because I can. That. This is why it's slow, for the record. It's defense. There you go. I have no idea why that one decided to mess up, but whatever. Fine. Oh, I don't want to do that. Whatever. Game slowing down a little bit, so I think something went wrong with me loading something's constantly or something, because it immediately started slowing down and having like input lag. So thankfully there's no rules against the RTA kind of thing for that. It's still the same. Anyway, next one is Magma Chamber fights. That is fine. So we gotta talk to Will here. Talk to him again. Nope, still fine. Does John, how you doing? Not roguelike, no. Metroidvania. It's Monster Sanctuary for the Switch, PC, PS4, Xbox. We will switch to you. I got this game into RPG Limit Break, and I'll be running it on the 19th. Oh yeah, no, definitely check it out. I know there's a Steam version. A Steam version demo. Excuse me. Also, hey, you're an Azure Dreams runner. Are you going to be running in the next tournament? It's been announced. It will start November 3rd. Yep. Where is, there it is. You guys behave now. Thank you. No, that's fair. I never want people to push themselves. So we're currently at 7 people right now, but we're gonna be doing a tournament based off the second tower. So, there you go. Yeah, it's a wonderful little Metroidvania where you use the monster's world overworld abilities to explore and continue through areas. So, Nope. Okay. I figured that's gonna be the case. Anyway, sneak by you guys. You're always by the door, jerks. So I really hate this guy in the center, and I really hate this guy. Their powers combined. I haven't tried to enter the second tower either, don't worry about it. Do more damage on this guy and this guy. Come on, do it. Thank you. Burrow. Yep. It's a very unique game. You should really check it out. It's quite cheap as well. The devs are actually really supportive of the speedrunning scene. The speedruns in general are kind of nuts. I do New Game Plus because I don't like egg RNG, but we have guides for everything on speedrun.com for all sorts of runs. So. I should build a target gun. What's that? I can mash A to win at this point here. I want the pony. Pronti? I'll have to check it out later. Never heard of that one. Ah, darn it. So Stronghold Dungeon Boss's team loadup didn't work. Oh, come off! That's all I have to do there. Whatever. Yeah, we'll just jump straight down, go to the left. Actually, you'd be surprised. I actually really dislike Metroidvanias. I like this one because the platforming is like really nice and smooth. There we go. Thank you, Will. This is basically a mash A to win match as well. I'll write it down in anyway. It's Pronti, right? And then Stronghold Dungeon Team. There you go. This poor guy just gets ripped apart by the status effects, and he can't actually do damage to these guys very well. Maybe I can just use Encapsulate and do this. So I'm basically guaranteed to win now at this point. Ranger. Crystal Shard. What we can do here is switch to the Horizon Beach fights. And off we go. get to the koi. Now you'd be surprised whether it's a speedrun game or not. Oh, absolutely. You know, thanks for chatting. I'm just doing this because I need practice for the run marathon, keeping track of chat. But I also, darn it. I actually did an offline segmented run, and if everything were to go right, I'd get 6 minute PB over the world record. Like, not just my record, but the world record. So I'll definitely take that. And with my new routing, I should get a PB no matter what today. And I just plan to do a few practice runs every now and then, so. So since we fought the Magma Chamber fight, we actually get the improved flight. If I didn't, I'd have to go to the right-hand side of Horizon Beach and fight the Savallo. That's the closest one I can get to easily. So we need to rescue Leonard here. Okay, for spikes. There's a Phoenix here and there. I will use this here. Jump and hit your head on that one and hold B. Likewise, I'll do the same thing. I don't trust this particular room. You get used to it after speedrunning it. But yeah, like when it comes to that room in particular, they jump way too much. It looks like you have a lot of space, but you really don't. So I'd much rather just play it safe and not get an encounter there. Let's go straight down. There we go. Again, don't know if that's intended or not. I never really tried. Entering into the hidden part of Horizon Beach where the two fights are, back to back actually. Thank you, Curved. The slope got me there. I used to grind here to level 20, which would take about 18 minutes. Now it doesn't. So I want these. They're combo potions. They're quite useful. They're just kind of a backup. I don't tend to get many of them during the run. What I want is not you, I want you to be hurt. I don't so much care for the little wisp guy. Don't care. There we go. Well, we can send you out and just use restoring shield. So what I want to do is I want them to kill everything. You know what? We can do that on the cat. Yeah, I don't mind that. That's fine. Restoring shield on you, actually. We'll actually keep you alive. We actually will keep you alive. Normally I would get rid of him, but honestly, the poison damage versus the cat is so good. So, let's do that. There you go. I want to keep you alive so we can do this as well. The bleed damage is going to do a lot of damage versus him, so it's all good. Oh, he's barely survived. That jerk. Oh, whatever. We have a mass potion for this reason. That was actually an extremely fast Julia fight. I don't mind that. And now we do the bleed side versus the Elder Gel here. Unfortunately, they are weak to water, but they also get a ton of bleed. And once you get the... once you get the barriers up, this guy really can't do much to you anymore. You'll see the bleed damage stack up. This is basically a preview for how Mad Lord will go. Please don't encapsulate. So now we have to grab the Sanctuary token. Just a shard back again. So I don't think we can buy anything new, if I remember correctly. Oh wait, we can. No, we can't. Okay, cool. So now we need to do the Underworld fights. And that is with here. This team, I should make credit. Bromanis made this team, like, and how things go. So it's definitely not me team building. My initial team was basically D9's or Dick9's team. We can go straight down here and we can fight Eric. And honestly, this is going really nicely. That Julia fight ended like 2 minutes faster than it really should have. Just by having the extra little guy there. Oh yeah, we go down this time. Also, I made a joke earlier that treasure chest was useless as a belt plus two. Yeah. So we get these guys, and we hit you once, and we hit you once. I'll barely be able to survive. Do this as much as possible. Kind of happy that guy didn't die, actually. I'm okay with that, because I can switch you out and just do Spore Cloud. Do a Slime Shot. Do a Slime Shot. So I want to stagger out the Dracogrand as much as possible. Ooh, no, I don't want you dead. Oh well. That's really not good. Yeah, the bleed's gonna disappear, and that's the annoying part. So, whatever. That's not the best, but I don't mind that as much. Yeah, I don't care, man. Like, you can hit them. Because I can just keep doing this and setting up a lot of... bleed on you. We can do that as well. This fight, okay, there might be something to having an extra Oculus in the back. These battles are going much quicker with the Oculus in the back other than bleed. No, we're still on the underworld boss stuff. So what we can do is switch to this. There we go. And what I want to do is fight this guy. A puts them on the other side, so I don't have to sneak by them. There you go. But B, I get the tether ability, the overworld ability. That's very important for later. Oh, weird. That's a banana. I've tried to route that into the game like 1,500 times. I can't. So. Ready, snuck by. We will switch to you. Just because this part's really annoying. Yeah, you're sitting on top of the box. You're a jerk. So just do that quickly. So I have 56 minutes or so for getting here is quite good. With the horse, you can fall straight down, not worry about the landing leg, which is a thing I should have mentioned. We can avoid these guys. They're not actually overly difficult to avoid. Hit this one while this is opening. You can make this go down once. And all you gotta do is go down. That's how you do it, Starhawk. Sorry, just too much red in my chat for names. So I didn't realize that was someone different. So what we want is we want to hit the lion. Good. Because he doesn't actually have recovery. Is the funny thing. Okay. So I don't mind that. I don't mind if he takes out all of them as well. No, not quite yet. I have another mass potion, don't I? No, I don't. That's fine. I can just target down this guy as much as possible. Thunderstorm, that gets rid of all of them. Do a potion. Come on, get that bleed up. So the whole point of this team is basically, I can't kill him with that. I was hoping to spread the bleed early. The whole point of this team is to basically cause a bleed and stagger it so it can go around and hit everyone. That's fine, I don't care. So guaranteed that unicorn's gonna die, and then the bleed that's gonna come from him is gonna get spread on the other ones. So, and the bears just like healing. So yeah, there you go. That should get rid of the Minotaur, or sorry, the Megatar. Wrong one, but whatever. One more turn, then he's dead. And then I think if I target down other guy, Barry or Burrows, I should be able to get rid of him as well. Wrong one, but whatever. Ah, close. This is the only hard, it's the only hard fight in this right now. Nope, we're still fine. So what we will do is we'll switch to you. And we'll switch to you. Get by you guys. Cool, thanks. So there's a different way into this place. I did it perfectly. Awesome, that feels good. Because if you open the door at the top, you have to exit out the top anyway. So all I've really done is to keep the door closed. And by keeping the door closed, that means I can just leave now the same way I just got in. Rivlinar pointed that out, and extremely thankful for that one, because you can't skip the door opening cutscene. So we're gonna switch to you again, because yeah, you're as large as the hallway, which is annoying. There we go. Switch to you again, because yeah. Thankfully they all stayed over there. Sometimes they actually stay on top of the lever. So now we can do this. Let's do this. I don't trust the... Yeah, they like to jump. There we go. Oh wait, I can do that now. I need this. That is a Phoenix Serum. That is the backup to backups. I don't like it. There you go. Sneak past them quickly. And this opens up this here. So I can go over here now and go around and go up and talk to Leonard, who had his spectral familiar stolen because story plot. Do not hit that lever over there just yet. That's very annoying. There we go. That's $1,000. No, it's silver here, I think. What I want to do is walk all the way around again. Now I can hit this. That goes all the way up again. I can go back out where Leonard was and hit the door, and then I have a way back up to the final fight here, which is the Dragonor. So. Also, I think my final team was like something with a mimic, if I remember correctly, in Plague Egg. Right here now. There we go. And the funny thing is this guy cannot stand up to bleed. Let's get some defense going. The Shadow Storm costs him basically. He hits everyone, so you'll see the bleed stack go up a lot very quickly. Let's do that. Crystal Shard. Now we can guide this. Because now we can use the improved flight as well to get to the mystical workshop. Oh wait, I gotta equip, there you go. Can't have a Metroidvania without having some sort of clock tower, right? See if I can avoid the jumpy guys here. Thanks for illustrating my point, you jerks. Oh, I messed that up. There you go. Always jump there. I should always hold B going into that room. A lot of treasure chests there, don't worry about it though. Okay. So the first key is on the right here. There's always a path down here you can do. I don't need the feather plus 5, so I don't have to do the full puzzle. That'll save me a few seconds. Thank you. Jerk. Okay, somehow I just managed to sneak by them. I'll take that. Trust this room for the life of me, just because, yeah. There's an orange in there, and I don't know what time it is anyway. What time is it? Did you know if you ask people around the world what time it is, you'll get different answers? It's crazy. Actually, what I should be doing is grabbing you. Yes, I do think I'm amusing as well, so don't bother pointing out how bad of a joke that was. So these guys can hurt. A lot? Phoenix here. Thankfully they all kind of go down one turn after another, but still, they're really scary here. Thank you, Ozzy. Yeah, why does that do no damage that time? I guess they all missed, but either way. Time. I can smash A to win. I don't care about ranking. So, because of me fighting the Goblin Pilot, we can now head back down here. I need to start feeding my monsters in like the last three teams. I can actually cheese everything without it, which is kind of funny. Problem is, I don't know where to kind of like put the shopping thing in the middle, just because Will is kind of annoying. So what I want here is I want some burn damage against this guy, and I want some poison damage versus this guy. Guys, they're gonna absolutely maul these guys in a second here. So we can do that again. Let's get some damage on this guy here as well. Then those two will die, and then I hopefully should have the bleed team out. Okay, we'll do that and that then. We can just get some stuff on you and Spore Cloud. We can burrow. Mass potion, and we can use that. I wouldn't mind actually if the front guy dies, because I can. We can just say mass potion. Phoenix tier, mass potion. I'm surprised that the guy in front hasn't too much bleed. It's kind of annoying. Mass potion. Although after this, I should be fine. All the bleed goes on the guy in the back now. Just do mass antidote. Mass antidote and mass potion. Don't like how this battle went, but honestly, it wasn't too slow. So I'll take it. There you go. So we can do you guys. I wrote it on this lost tower. It's a abandoned tower. I'm an idiot. What I need to do again. I hate you. Weekly 200. Cloud. Pretty sure they can't kill the front guy anyway, so that's all good. So do mass antidote, get rid of this crap, mass potion, and then some regular potion, which is on this side now. Potion. There we go. That's what I want because this will, A, I'll be able to survive. Get rid of that age guy there. Nice. I saw that. So I do a mass antidote to get rid of some of this crap. Mass antidote, get rid of some of the other crap. And then we can do a mass potion. Everyone's favorite fight. Okay, good. He should go down no matter what next turn, which makes me happy. And then hopefully they all go down, which is what I want. Burrow, Burrow, and Spore Cloud. Okay, we've got one weakness at least. Okay, I don't like him surviving. That's not really what I wanted, but okay. So I do a mass antidote, get rid of this crap. There we go. potion, gas antidote. Now it has to be mass potions for a bit here. And these guys. Get rid of the weakness armor again. So I had to focus on this match pretty heavily here. Do mass antidote. Mass potion. Mass potion. Just top up everyone. Almost there. That, we have to do mass. Okay. That should be game then. So with the way this battle works is he has an aging team, which really sucks. But if you keep the damage down. Oh, you barely survived. Oh no 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 no. Okay, no no, we're still fine. It's still staggered. It's still staggered. And everything goes on to this guy here. And he's the last one with the aging on him. I don't care, man. You can kill him. And then Phoenix tier. Mass potion. Mass potion. There we go. Because now they actually can't really damage me anymore. So that fight gets extremely sketchy if you fail to keep the bleed back. Do that quickly. This is the last kind of really sketchy fight, truthfully. I need more practice fighting him, but all my save files always end before this. So what we want to do is get rid of you. Because, yeah, that thing's pretty damn annoying, truthfully. There we go. So try our best to do what we can for bleed on that one. Hopefully the little guy in front doesn't use restore, but okay. And this is another one where we have to prioritize mass antidotes. Mass potion, and then we can do a lifeline just because. What we want is them to build up a lot of bleed so we can pass it to the monsters when they come in. But the problem is they also have congeal, which kind of upsets my damage calculations, so I really want to get rid of that as fast as possible. Yeah, you can see the 11 and 15 doing a good chunk of damage there. Mass antidotes. Antidotes, and mass potion. Again, we want to get rid of as much of the stuff as possible just because it is that annoying. Yep, yeah, cool. So, that guy being in the center there is actually really decent because he's not going to really do much. So, we can just do that. One simple mass antidote, and we can go for a spore cloud again. And you'll see the damage rack up really quickly. Unfortunately, all three spectrals are out, and that's a bad, because, yeah, bad. But overall, it's not the end of the world, just because I got the five barrier going, so I can kind of survive while, you know, the line goes, and it's two versus three, basically. And I win. Antidote just to make sure. We do a mass potion, and then we do another mass potion. And And basically it's mass potion, mass antidotes, just to make sure nothing else can happen here. There goes him, and then I mash it again. So the last thing we do is this one. Okay. And now we're on to the final fights. We want to get rid of you. I'll survive one turn no matter what. That will make it so that dies next turn. And then I gotta put a lot of stuff on the Ashura. Didn't want you to die, but we can just do that. Oh no, Dracogran! No, 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 no. That's bad. I might have to restart this. Don't kill him. Okay, good. We'll switch you to that. I forgot about that. That's my bad. Dracogran really likes killing the plant, but I can't have the plant die yet. So. We can do that and that. We can do that. We can do a mass potion. That's good. There we go. Because now we can just do mass potions and whatnot. Not ideal. I didn't think that one through. That's my bad. But the guy in the back will rack up a lot of bleed as well, so. Just gotta make sure I can keep things under check. Mass potions. Once I get rid of the guy in the back, I'm basically golden because it's 2v3 and I can survive that kind of damage. So. There we go. Kinda don't mind that. We can do a Phoenix tier. We can do a big potion. And we can do a mass potion. Okay, next turn, the Mad Eye will go down. That's more than fine, so you can do Mass Antidote, a Mass Potion, and a Mass Antidote. You can honestly just straight up attack through. And now it's on to the final fight. This is where the Phoenix Serum comes in handy. Okay, we got the weakness. That's really nice. I just don't want him to... Okay, that's good. Because we can Phoenix tier you. We can Mass Potion, and then we can Mass Antidote. We gotta get rid of these status effects. Okay, good. That's ideal. So we do that. Mass Potion and Mass Potion. Again, that's fine. We can do a Phoenix tier. Him dying's not the worst in the end. I just don't want the both bears to die, essentially. So I want to make sure I get rid of these debuffs as fast as possible. Ooh, that's a lot of damage. Can't control crits though. And this is where we have the Phoenix Serum to come in handy. Because we can use Phoenix tier now. Mass potion and a mass potion. One more turn. I think we win because, yeah, he can't kill him. So GG, that is a world record. There you go. Yay. So what did I post in the Monster Sanctuary Discord? Oh. Let's do that as well for a second. I posted, was it in-game time of 1:35:54? This was 1:31 something. So yeah, that's a... I should probably contact RPG Limit Break and tell them to lower the estimate then. Cause that's a... There's a heck of a drop. Cause my estimate is 210. So... But hey, this is what like severe rerouting works. And then I had to figure out what happened to the Stronghold Dungeon one. I had to go back and watch the VOD. I'm pretty sure I had 12 skill points, and I'm pretty sure I had that. Oh, everyone's staying away from the Mimic again. I love that. I don't know why the Mimic is the one that stays in there, but yeah, fear the Mimic. Ugh. All right. So, just to run down the teams now. First of all, Stronghold Dungeon. What did you... Oh, you guys weren't even saved. You didn't even have skill points. Wow, okay, that's really bad of me. Because if you load up a preloaded team, they will load up whatever they had. So, I just didn't give them stuff. So, that's pretty bad. But yeah, so to run down kind of what's happening, this was made by Bromanis as well. I just stole all the strategies. So no credit here, but credit to where it goes. These ones can basically kill the blob team in two, prevents any healing, and these ones just destroy the steam golem. That's basically what's going on. Monk, just these top three, earth, 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 poison, poison, fatal upkeep. That's that one. Matar, burn damage, fatal upkeep. Get in, ha ha ha, status effects. And also, all these guys always have, like, the cauldron and this stuff going on. So they do quite a bit of stuff, status effects and stuff. Zazimus 1, this is a lead, take out the Grummy. This is a lead, take out everything else with status effects. It's great. Forest bosses plus Akut. Akut can't die, or how do you pronounce the whale's name? I don't know. But basically... He can't kill them, and you just use Phoenix Tears. You buy 99 at the start. You can see I only have 11,000 bucks left. I barely have enough, but I do have enough to buy all the stuff I want in the game. Which is, you know, yay. And like I said, I was actually really surprised by how fast the Julia fight and stuff went. So there might be strategy to basically shove like a fourth Oculus in the back just to do the status effects. Because that was a lot of... ship damage there. Or, again, it might just be boils down to is more fatal upkeep and grummies and stuff like that. Or grummies, sorry, fungies. Stronghold Dungeon boss, again, Beetaloid, same kind of thing, spread fire that, let fatal upkeep take out the thing. Maybe chamber fights. Honestly, get rid of that damn moth. That's the main goal, but also, if you can poison things, yay. If not, go for bleed. I'm sure I can't fight the Oculuses as well. Horizon Beach, Julia is weak to poison, and then Bleed cleans up. Bleed just takes out the Elder Gel like it's shown. Underworld, this is Eric, Leonard, and Draconar. All of them just generally work really well together. Goblin Pilot and Will. I don't know where the shopping trip is in between, because after the Goblin Pilot, Like, I guess I have to do the shopping anyway, because whatever, but basically until this point, you don't feed your monsters in the run. And because of that, that's probably where my time save came from. And, I'm coming to bed soon enough. Sarah's heading to bed. I told her I'd stay up until I was done the run, so, you know. Anyway, when it comes to Draknar, he sets up a lot of bleed on himself by hitting them, and then basically these guys, you want to take out the lion and the unicorn if possible. The unicorn normally wipes everything and you kind of have to resort to bleed, so it's not the greatest. Goblin Pilot will, sorry, that's what I was talking about. Goblin Pilot bleed sort of works. You can also do Oculus's and then switch to the bleed just to get some status effects on, just speed things up, but honestly, the best thing against him is chill. The Lost Tower Alchemist, or the Abandoned Tower, now that I know. I'm not renaming things. It's too annoying to like rename things. All of them are really, really good. I'm actually surprised how fast Zazamos 2 went. Chimes at the end as well. Going for the elephant in the back is honestly probably better. I always try to go for the little wispy guy. Which I can never remember his name anyway. It's honestly easier doing the other one. And then Marduk and Madlord, it's the same thing. You want to get rid of the Sitsune, and you want to get rid of the Ashura. And then once all three of them get wiped, you want the Dracogran to beat the crap out of the Voila. And then basically, since they all have Thorn Tendrils on, they all create a lot of bleed. But because of the Thorn Tendril, you know, apply bleed stack to attackers, it does quite a bit. But since you can keep reviving and then keeping these guys alive, the Dracogran will always kill this one. And basically he'll die from bleed and then spread to everything. And then since he dies and it spreads to the other two, those two will die and then spread it back to the remaining ones. So it staggers really nicely. And just at the end, you saw that, you know, the Phoenix Serum is crucial. If one of the Mulbers go down, revive them with the Phoenix Serum, just because it gives you full recovery. You don't have to worry about being just shy and dying from a crit. They are purposely, you know, bulky. And with the only thing I feed all the monsters as well is literally just almonds for defense, because that damage reduction makes a big difference. But yeah, that is the entire run. So I am done. I will check what the actual... I purposely staggered the timer to after I ended it. But if I were to quit out and go back in here... What was the time me coming into the final room? So I looked at the... Let me see here. Is sub-131 entering the last fight? I had on my chat window if I typed the start. Oh, and it was the other one as well. There's two time things because I have my splits. Warm underwear was at 1350. I did not get out in the first try, so if you would have deducted like a minute from that, or even like 30 seconds, let's say. That'd be 12:30. My other time was 13:50, so 50-second time save. And then 1:31 entering the final fight. That would have been after the Abandoned Tower bosses. So I think I entered there just before sub 1:30. So okay, there we go. 1:26. Okay. Yeah, that's considerably. I just want to like point that out, like I have the world record by a lot right now, but this also comes with like the new patch and all this other stuff. But if you go to New Game Plus Glitchless, real-time world record or previous world record by Priyoshu was 141.22 RTA. Mine was 134. So I shaved 7 minutes off. And in-game time, that's why I took a video so I can check what it was. Bum, 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 bum. What was it? Okay, 131. So that was 9 minutes, 21 seconds faster in game time. So, oh yeah, absolutely. I'm gonna head to bed. I wanted to get this done and I'll submit this to the leaderboard for DS9 to verify. But there you go, free routing, redoing all the teams, doing a lot of damage calculations and risk management. Definitely paid off. I will have to contact the RPG limit break staff later and basically say, can you lower my estimate? Because oops. Yeah. But yeah, 131.02 and 134, so about 3 minutes. I know I also quit out of the game just because the game was running a little bit sluggish after the stronghold dungeon bosses. I think that's about 40 minutes into the run, right? I did that. Yeah, about 40 minutes. And that's just because, like, I don't know what I did. I triggered something and everything started lagging and I started missing inputs. And I had to be careful for those fights. But, yeah, I'm done. I will see if anyone is around if streaming. If not, I will just let Autohost find someone because, yeah. No, I will just let Autohost find someone. There's no one really relevant to speedrunning. Anyway, everyone take care. Yay, GG, world record and all that. I'm just really, really pleased with my effort. I've done like 11 offline runs or 10 offline runs overall, all segmented. So it's nice to actually get one recorded and, you know, live. So. But yeah. I'll watch the VOD back and get some details, but I think I'm done. So thanks for watching. Autohost will find someone. Move my splits over here. And yeah. Hey, look, sub 2 hours. Actually, as of right now, the recording just now is my custom robo speedrun. The 159.20. So that's goofy. All right. See everyone.